At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
High school for the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance pregame show on WROI. Time now for the starting lineups. First for the Bremen Lady Lions with a record of 4-7. At one guard will be a 5'5 senior, Jasmine Schaefer. The other guard, a 5'6 freshman, Alexis Jennings. The third guard will be a 5'6 sophomore, Michaela Box. At one forward, 5'11 sophomore, Chelsea Hubbard. And the other forward will be a 5'8 junior, Rachel Zarnecki.
The Lions are coached by Tanya Lucas.
The Rochester Lady Zebras, they have a record of 10-3. At one guard will be a 5'2 sophomore, Alexa Holland. The other guard will be a 5'4 sophomore, Becky Malko. At one forward, 5'8 junior, Bailey Abbott, her first start of the year, second start of the year. Second, the other forward is going to be a 5'7 senior, Carly Murphy. And in the middle of the night for the Lady Zebras will be a 5'10 senior, Breanne Pollock. Rochester coached by Mr. Tony Stasiak in his 14th season. That's going to wrap up the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance pregame show here on WROI. Tip is close here at Rochester High School. Brad Thomas comes back in, and like we said before, this one, the paint game should belong to the Zebras tonight.
Yeah, you would hope so. I think Pollock should have pretty well have her way down low. Hopefully the rebounding advantage as well.
You know, we've seen this before. Rochester does have the inside advantage, but Rochester's guards seem to force it or try to force it inside to utilize that post.
And I think if I may say, if we can recognize it, you know that the other opposing coach has already recognized it.
Whoa.
And they're going to set their defense accordingly to try and keep that ball from going low.
That hurts my feelings. The Rochester Lady Zebras on their home whites, the Bremen Lady Lions in the road greens. Rochester will go right to left and Bremen left to right. It'll be Pollock and Hubbard to jump center for the respective squads. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Rochester High School in the varsity contest. The JV contest tonight went to Bremen over Rochester 42-32. And here we go. The ball is up in the center circle, and the tip controlled by Bremen. Hubbard gives across to Zarnicki. Now to Box. Rochester in a 1-3-1 zone to start. Box high on the right side to Schaefer. Schaefer in the corner to Jennings, back to Box, top of the key.
Bremen pretty well playing the perimeter with just Zarnecki inside.
Box will take the jumper from the elbow. It's too long, and the rebound comes skied in from Becky Malko, and she gets shoved out of bounds on a body check by Box, so that'll be the team first on the Bremen Lady Lions.
Bremen foul, number 12,
McKayla Box. Rochester will have the ball for the first time tonight. They'll trigger it in on the far side, right in front of the student section. Murph will do that. And it looks like Bremen will start in their, half-court travel, looks like.
Yeah.
X crosses the timeline to Malko. Bounce pass to Murphy. Murphy splits a double team. No look pass down low to Bailey Abbott. Her jumper off the window is no good. Her put back on the way is partially blocked. And Bremen picks it up. Gives out to Schaefer. Schaefer runs length of the floor. Layup over Murphy is too hard. No good. And X gets the rebound. Holland now runs for Rochester. No score early on at Rochester. Holland on the right wing. Spot up three on the way for the Lady Zebras. Is off the mark. No good. Rebound tipped around. And Paula comes out of there with it. Gives to Malko. And she'll reset. Now to Murphy on the left wing. Murph against the double team. Looks like the zone defense. Loses the handle of the basketball on the baseline now. Cut off by the double team. Bounce pass out to Malko. She fakes a three. Now drives in the lane. Loses the handle right through the legs of Pollock and out of bounds. And it'll go back to Bremen. A minute 10 gone here in the first quarter. And no score here at Rochester. And Bremen with the basketball.
Rochester not being shy. They're aggressively attacking that Bremen defense.
Good to see. Michaela Box crosses the timeline left. Now on the near side of Jennings. Jennings stands the ball over her head. Now down to her waist. Now to Schaefer. Back to Jennings. Free throw line to Zarnicki. Zarnecki, one dribble in the paint. Got to get rid of it. Back to Jennings. Now to Schaefer. Her 15-footer is way off the mark. No good. Malky Balco the rebound and run. Balco then is forced out of bounds again by Box, who is their leading scorer, and that's going to be foul number two. And now Bremen will have to go to their bench and bring in Shannon Arndt, a 5'7 freshman. And probably Michaela Box, who, like I said, is the Bremen leading score because of the two injuries. She's the leading scorer right now for Bremen. and she is going to sit down for a while. Make that 6:25 to play first quarter, no score. 2-3 zone now by the Lady Lions. Holland to Malco, three, right wing is short. She gets her own rebound. Great follow by Malco. Loses the handle. B has it in the lane. Leaner over the defense is no good. In and out. And the rebound to Jennings. Alexis Jennings brings up the floor. Crossover dribble works to her left side. And now has her pass picked off by Malco. Becky Malco in for the layup. It's off the glass and good. Rochester strikes first with 2 minutes gone here in the opening quarter. It's 2-0. Jennings pushes off. No call. Out of Art on the right wing, she travels. Good defense by the Lady Zebras of forcing that turnover.
Rochester being really active on both sides of the ball, both sides of the floor.
I wonder how long they can do that. They only have five players.
Right. Well, I never think conditioning was the problem. I think it was coming down sideways on your foot.
Holland kicks it out to Malco. She drives it left, switches directions, out to Holland, lobs it inside to Pollock, now outside to Murphy, the three on the way, top of the key is good!
And I think I've seen them take more three-pointers or attempts at three-pointers in this game than I have all year.
30-second Bremen timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Five and a half minutes to go here in the first quarter at Rochester. The Lady Zebras leading 5-0, and Rochester looking at their 2-2-1 zone press and probably the half-court trap as well. Hubbard over the top of the defense to Schaefer. Bounce pass to Arndt. Her jumper from the free throw line's off the mark. No good. Out it with a rebound. Gives the Holland. Rochester runs. Holland left side of the floor. Hesitates. Crossover dribble and backs it back outside behind the arc. Top of the key to Murphy. Quickly to Malco. Becky drives it, loses the handle, right to Pollock. B backs her way in on the baseline. Cut off by the defense, out of Malco. Now to Holland, top of the key, left side to Murph. Murph at the elbow. Skip pass to Malco. 15-footer right baseline is off the mark, no good. And Hubbard for Bremen at the rebound. Gives to Jennings, and Alexa Jennings runs it through the center circle for Bremen, going to our right. Rochester up 5-0 with 4:45 to play in the first quarter. To Zarnicki on the baseline. Has it taken away? You're going to have a tie-up, and Rochester's going to get it on the turnover.
Possession error.
4:40 to play. First quarter. Rochester up 5-0, and it'll be Rochester basketball. And the leading scorer and leading ball handler for Bremen, Michaela Box, is out of the game with two personal fouls. Through the center circle goes Holland. Works to the left side against the 2-3 zone. High on the left side. Now high on the right side to Malco. Malco studies. Left side to Holland. X feeds down low to Abbott. Abbott against the triple team. Kicks it out to B. Quickly to Malco. Just inside the arc. Right side jumpers on the way off the mark. No good. Pollock with the rebound. Dribbles it off her foot. Picked up by Abbott. Down to Malco. Outside to Holland. Wide open three left wing. Is short. No good. And the rebound to Hubbard. Ahead to Schaefer for Bremen. Bremen runs to our right. And then she has her pocket picked by Holland. X runs to our left now. Up by five. Holland. Heel drop jumper in the lane is no good. The putback by Abbott is partially blocked. Ball being fought for. Bremen comes out of there with it. And Jennings gives the head to Arndt. Arndt right side. Behind the arc picks up her dribble. Now is to Jennings behind the right side for Bremen. At the free throw line to Hubbard. Now to Arndt. 15-footer is partially blocked off the side of the backboard and picked up by Abbott. Bailey gives to Murph. And now Coach Stasiak says, let's say it's slow up a little bit. We're up by five with 3:35 to play in the first quarter.
Rochester getting a lot of good looks. They're just not able to knock any of them down yet.
Holland, lob pass over the defense. Gives to Abbott somehow. Back to Holland. Drives it inside. Backs it out behind the three-point line. Spots up for three. It's on the way. It's good. 8-0 Rochester. And you said it there during the break. Rochester's taken more three-point shots here in this quarter than we've seen in a long time.
They've attempted five, and they've hit two. So
Bremen breaks the press. Jennings high on the right side near the Rochester bench. Dump pass down low is knocked out of bounds by, oh, it's going to say last touch by Bremen. And Malco got it off the hands of Sarnicki, and it goes out of bounds. So Rochester going to get it back on another Bremen turnover.
That's the fifth Bremen turnover.
3:06 to play, first quarter. Rochester up. Rochester up 8-0, under 3 to play in the first quarter. Murphy through the center circle, works to our left. 2-3 zone by Bremen. Murphy breaks the double team, kicks out to Holland. Holland fakes around the defense to Murphy, left side to Malco. Malco loses the handle, ball loose. Going to have a fight for it. It's going to be tied up, and Bremen going to get it back. So a turnover on the Rochester Lady Zebras.
Lady Z's attempted 23 three-pointers against Whitco, but they trailed most of that game on Saturday, so that doesn't totally surprise me.
Czarnicki drives the baseline, out of control, throws it off the legs of Malkin, out of bounds. And he's going to stay with Bremen. Yeah, Tony said that they shot 28% in that game at
wow.
Whitco. And even with missing basically 25 points, still almost pulled that out. Jennings looks to trigger it in for Bremen, stands with the ball overhead. She's got to hurry and get it in. Does so to Hubbard. Turnaround jumper on the block. She's on the way. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Zebra ball number 24, Bailey Abbott.
2.5 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 8-0.
Number 13, Chelsea Hubbard.
Chelsea Hubbard, a 5'11 sophomore at the line to shoot two for the Lady Lions. First one on the way is good. She'll have one more.
That's Bremen's first point of the game.
8-1. Second one for Hubbard. Eyes it, flies it. Good again as it rolls over in front of the rim and goes in. It's 8-2. So Bremen breaks the 8-0 run by the Lady Zebras. A 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Quickly up the floor is Holland through the center circle. Behind her back dribble. Left wing to Malco. Becky against the 2-3 zone. Back to Holland, left corner. Holland inside the 2-3 zone, out to Malco, now to Murphy, fakes the three, drives, shot over B. Pollock, is no good, but a foul coming on Bremen, and Murph will go to the line to shoot two. Pollock did a great job there screening her person off and giving Murphy a pretty good look at the rim.
Yep, Czarnicki going to pick up her first team third.
Murph eyes the first one, lets it fly, and it's no good, she'll have one more. 8-2, Rochester with 2:15 to play in the first quarter. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. One more coming for the senior, Carly Murphy. Eyes a second one, lets her fly, and this one's good. 9-2, Rochester. Bremen has it, and Rochester will pick it up about three-quarter court. Jennings, couple of dribbles, gets it to the timeline, cross the timeline, lob over the defense, off the head of Carly Murphy, out of bounds, and it'll stay with Bremen. Intended for Schaefer, and Murphy did a good job breaking up that pass. So it'll be out of bounds to Bremen, baseline right. And Jennings will look to trigger it in. 2:05 to play first quarter. Gets it into Art quickly to the top of the key to Czarnicki. Czarnicki bounce pass in the corner to Jennings. She drives the baseline against Abbott, cut off by the base defense. Ball tipped away, it's loose. And we're going to have a ball must have been knocked out of bounds by Czarnicki. I thought maybe they're going to whistle that against B. Pollock.
I thought
but,
so too, yeah.
Or a tie-up at that. But they're going to say Czarnicki had the ball and touched the out-of-bounds line, so Rochester will get it back. 1:50 to play, first quarter, 9-2 Rochester. Malco holds high on the right side against the 2-3 zone, now in the corner to Murphy. Murphy looking to get it inside, now feeds Pollock down low. She's under the basket now. She goes up for a shot, blocked from behind, and now Bremen picks it up. Jennings has it. Lions run to our right. Jennings to the center circle with 90 seconds to play, first quarter. The Lady Zebras up 9-2. Arndt is fouled as she tries to split the double team, and Bailey Abbott is going to pick up that foul, and Tony Stasiak will go to the bench and send in freshman Alexa Garrison. 1:28 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 9-2, and Bremen has it out of bounds again. Alexis Jennings for the basketball, and Bremen will go back to their bench and send in Gabby Buck, a 5'7 junior, and Czarnicki will sit down. Jennings will look to trigger it in. Stands with the ball above her head. Law pass inside. Goes to Hubbard. Hubbard against the double team. Out to Jennings. Quick three on the way. Is off the mark. No good. Weak side rebound. Comes down to Pollock, who gives to Holland. Rochester runs to our left. Up by 7. Holland right side of the floor. Hesitates. Accelerates. Against the double team. Takes it out to Murph on the right wing. Now top to Malco. Malco against the 2-3 zone. Loses her handle. Kicks it out to Holland, and she'll reset on the right wing with a minute 5 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up by 7. Now make that Malco between the rings. Brett dribbles it off her foot again and regains the dribble. Drives in the paint. Dump pass to Pollock. Jumper on the way. No good. A foul coming on Hubbard, and that's going to send B. Pollock to the line for 2.
That away, White.
55.2 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 9-2, and B. Pollock has a line to shoot two for her Lady Zebras.
Hubbard's going to pick up her first foul, team fourth.
And after the first free throws, our Nikki will come back in for Bremen. Be ready. First one is up and good for the senior. She'll have one more. Zarnicki back in and Hubbard to sit. Hubbard, their only points in this first quarter right now, and that came from the free throw line. Rochester's lead back to 8. Pollock with one more for the Lady Z's. Under a minute to play in the first quarter. Be second. Good again. 11-2 Rochester. And again, Rochester will pick him up. Three-quarter court press. As Jennings has it with 50 seconds in the first quarter. Now to Schaefer, quickly across the timeline is Zarnicki, and down to Buck, who travels and no call. Out to Schaefer. Schaefer to a wide open Schaefer, or make that Jennings down low. Ball tipped away. Jennings picks it up. Ball tipped again. Schaefer has it. Back to Jennings. She runs the baseline, throws a shot up, partially blocked. B. Pollock with the rebound. Now we're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go to Rochester. 34 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester up 11-2, and probably will milk the clock for the final shot of the period.
Yeah, that's what you would hope to see happen.
X, left side of the floor. Across the timeline, left, 25 seconds to play, first quarter. 11-2 Rochester. X holds near the volleyball line, left side of the floor. 2-3 zone now extended out to the volleyball line. Now to Malco near the timeline with 18 seconds. Becky Malco holds with 15, now drives to 13. Backs it out and resets to Holland with 10. Her three on the way is short. Rebound to Bremen with 8. Now Jennings has it with 6. Crossover dribble with 4. Crosses the timeline of 3. Jennings inside the arc. Kicks it out to Zarnicki with 1. Jumper at the buzzer on the way is no good. After 1, Rochester leads 11-2. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
The second quarter we go at Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras lead Bremen 11-2, and the Lady Lions will start with the basketball going to our right. Alexa Garrison still on the floor for Rochester. She replaced Bailey Abbott late in that first quarter. Jennings gets it into Box, who's back in the game, playing with 2 personal fouls now for Bremen. Michaela Box, well rested in that first quarter, played what, two minutes?
Yeah, you're right, yeah.
Hubbard back into the game as well. Gets it down low to Zarnicki, and she is fouled on the entry pass by B. Pollock. And it'll be out of bounds to Bremen, baseline left, with 12 seconds gone here in this second quarter with Rochester up by 9.
Pollock's first, team third.
Box now will be the trigger. Person here on the left wing or on the left side of the floor underneath the basket. Lobs in and over the defense to Jennings. Jennings drives. Jumper from the free throw line on the way off the back of the rim. No good. Ball being tipped around. Murphy comes out of there with it. Murph runs for Rochester.
And Malco's coming up limping.
Oh, that's not good.
No.
She is limping. You're right. She has it now top of the key. She drives in the paint. Feeds down low to Garrison. Garrison kicks it out to Holland left wing. X against a double team. Wrap around pass to Malco. Top of the key and at the volleyball line. Back to Holland. Cross court to Murph. Murph dumps down low to Pollock. B backs away in. Throws up a shot over Hubbard. It's no good. Gets her own rebound. Loses the handle. Ball loose. Malco picks it up. And then throws it out away. Tough to handle a pass at your feet. And Malco reties that left shoe. I got to wonder if that's the one that's bothering her a little bit.
And she seems to be not too obvious a limp anymore, but that last trip down the floor was really causing her problems.
Fox works against Garrison, kicks it out to Zarnicki, and she travels. 7:04 to play, first half. Rochester up 11-2, and they've got the basketball right in front of the student section, and we'll bring it up the floor. Holland across the timeline against the 2-3 zone. To Malco at the volleyball line, right side of the floor.
So anywhere where there's more than 4 students sitting together, that's a...
Well, it's where the student section would be
okay.
If there was one tonight. Malco gets a pass from Holland. Now right corner to Murph. Murph looking down low against a double team. One dribble out to Malco high on the right side, top to Holland. X fakes a 3, now drives into paint. Layup is on the way, no good. Ball being tipped around. Murphy comes out of there with it. Murph forces a shot, no good. Pollock's putback is good. 13-2 Rochester, and I believe that was the first shot of the quarter, yes?
Yes.
They struggled a little bit from the floor in that first quarter, did the Lady Zebras. Jennings gets it to Czarnicki in the paint, and Czarnicki travels again.
Wow. Bremen having trouble with the turnovers. Rochester having trouble just hitting a shot.
Well, 13-2 Rochester.
You'll have days like that.
Yeah, I had nothing. I apologize.
That's all right.
6:05 to play first half. Rochester up 13-2. Holland holds on the left wing behind the arc. 2-3 zone by the Lady Lions, or 2-1-2 zone the way it looks. Outside to Malco, it's a volleyball line. Back to Holland, and now we're going to have a foul underneath as Murphy hits the deck hard. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester on the far sideline.
So that foul's coming against Czarnicki. That's her second.
Under six to play in the first half. Rochester up 13-2. Murphy gets the pass in from Malco. She drives. Cut off of the defense. Out to Holland. Three on the way. Right baseline is off the mark. Good Garrison with the rebound. Her putback no good, but a foul coming on Bremen. You know, Tony was pretty high on Alexa Garrison after the Whitco game. She played a lot of great minutes, and now she's being rewarded for that with a varsity action.
Yeah, she's doing pretty well. She's down low fighting for position and looking for rebounds.
So Alexa Garrison, a freshman for the Lady Zebras, at the line to shoot two. First one on the way. Bow off the back of the iron, no good. She'll have one more.
Hey, relax. You got it. Come on.
5:49 to play first half. Garrison with one more for Rochester. Alexa's second one. No good. Too hard again. And the rebound to Hubbard. Hubbard now gives to Box, and Bremen runs to our right. Box, right side to Jennings in the corner. Down low to Hubbard. Hubbard, jumper off the window is good. Hubbard has all four of Bremen's points, and it's 13-4.
And that's their first field goal at the 5:30 mark of the second quarter.
The lob pass inside is knocked away by Czarnicki, who gives the head to Box. Box, cross lane pass to Jennings. Her layup is good. And it's 13-6. Bailey Abbott will come in the next opportunity. Right side of the floor is Holland. Between her legs, dribble, picks it up, gives to Malco. Quickly left side to Murph. Murph holds. In the corner to Holland. Lob pass to B. B in the paint. Cut off by Hubbard. Kicks it out to Malco. She's in the paint. Kicks it out to Murph. She drives it left. Pull-up jumper from 10 feet is way too long. And the rebound is Czarnicki and Bremen. Rochester's lead is down to 7 with 4:50 to play in the first half. Jennings kicks it out to Arndt on the right baseline. Wrap-around pass to Czarnicki. She loses the handle, but Box is right there to pick it up against Garrison. Crossover dribble now drives it left to Hubbard. Over the top of the defense to Jennings. She runs the baseline. Jumper over Pollock is no good. Rebound fought for, and Murphy comes out of there with it. Now Rochester runs with the numbers. Holland, left side, hesitates, now works her way right in the paint, throws up a shot out the window, no good, too hard. Holler makes that. Garrison with the rebound, no good, and Hubbard for Bremen with the board. 4:15 to play, first half, Rochester up 13-6. A lot of great opportunities for both teams, can't really get the ball to fall. Box to Arndt. Arndt, pass is kicked away by Holland, and it'll stay with Bremen right in front of the Rochester bench as Bailey Abbott comes back into the game, and Alexa Garrison will sit. Also coming back in is Jasmine Schaefer for Bremen, and Arndt will come out. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 4:08 to play first half, Rochester by 7. Jennings quickly gets it into Box near the timeline, and she drives it right, gives it to Schaefer. Down low, pass taken away by Pollock, who now gives to Murphy. Another turnover on Bremen. Rochester runs up by 7. Cross-court pass to Malco. She holds to the volleyball line. Now drives it to the three-point line. Spot up three on the way is too hard. The rebound put back by Abbott is partially blocked. Pollock's put back is good. Rochester back by 9. Right place at the right time right there for B.
Yeah, you're right. Nice weak side rebound.
And the layup wide open to Czarnicki is good. Nice job by Bremen breaking that press, and Czarnicki had a wide open shot. 15-8. Rochester, 3:25 to play, first half. Ooh, Murphy, cross-court pass to Holland. X, three, right side, good!
Got to figure she's going to hit some of those sooner or later.
Well, you know what they tell good shooters to do? Keep shooting.
Absolutely.
Boxes three, top of the key, is good. It bounced on the front of the rim twice and fell over and went in. 7-point lead for Rochester, 18-11. 3 minutes to play, first half. Holland to Malco. Back to Holland, right side. Crossover dribble, works to the free throw line. Out to Murph. Murph on, behind the arc, drives to the down low to the baseline. Her shot's partially blocked, picked up by Zarnicki. And now to Jennings. Raymond runs to our right, down by seven. 2:45 to play, first half. Box face to three. Steps back, gives to Jennings. So she'll fire a three up the side of the backboard, no good. Pollock with a rebound, now gives to Malco. Rochester the basketball going to our left, leading by seven, with 2.5 to play in the first half. Holland again for three, short. Rebound fought for. Abbott's putback is no good. She gets her own rebound and then taken away by Jennings. Another point-blank shot goes unanswered by the Lady Zebras. And now Box has it. Sends left side to Schaefer. 2:10 to play, first half. Box to Hubbard. To Jennings for three. Good! I think they bring that same play every time down the floor.
I think you're right, too, and they're starting to find their range.
You're right. The lead is cut to four, under two to play in the first half. 18-14 Rochester, 2-3 zone by Bremen. Malco has her shot blocked. Ball being tipped around is still loose. Abbott has it, gives it to Pollock. Her jumper, no good, and she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Nice job by Abbott, the fight for the loose ball.
A minute 43 to play in the first half. Rochester up 18-14, and B. Pollock, who's 2-for-2 from the free throw line, will go to the line to shoot two here as Alexa Garrison will come back in after the first free throw.
That was Hubbard's second foul.
B. has two. The senior's first one is in and out, no good, so I have one more. So Garrison will come back into the game, and she'll replace Abbott.
Number 34.
Also back in.
Odell.
For Bremen is Arndt. Hannah Odell comes in for the first time tonight.
Number 23.
And she replaces Murphy with a minute 43 to play in the first half. Rochester by four. Murphy with an opportunity to push this lead to five with the next freebie. Be ready. Eyes a second and lets it fly, and this one's good. 19-14 Rochester. Again, a minute 40 to play in the first half. Bremen with the basketball going to our right. Fox runs a point for Rochester, and they're back in that 1-3-1 zone. Schaefer high on the right side, inside the three-point line. Outside is Zarnicki. Back to Schaefer. 15-footer right side is off the mark. No good. Good heavens. And now Arndt comes flying in over the back of Malco. Is going to be whistled for a foul, and I think Rochester is going to shoot free throws. Yes.
Freeman foul, number 23, Shannon Arndt.
So Becky Malco will go to the line to shoot one in the bonus for Rochester, who lead by five with a minute 27 to play in the first half.
One and one, number 20, Becky Malco.
Malco coming off an 18.9, I believe, at Whitco. Malco eyes her first one, lets it fly, and it's too hard, no good, and the rebound to Arndt. Too hard off the back of the rim. And now Box has a minute 20 to play. First half, Rochester by five. Box works left side. Now inside the arc, steps back, loses the handle, feeds down low to Zarnicki. Her shot's no good. Rebound to Schaefer. The baby hook is in the lane and good. And now the lead is three, closest they've been in a long time. Under a minute to play, first half. Rochester leads 19-16. Holland has it, now to Odell, quickly to Malco on the near side. 2-3 zone by the Bremen Lady Lions to Holland. Back to Malco. Malco backs it out to the volleyball line. Cross court pass to Holland. 5 feet behind the arc. Long three for the Lady Zebras is off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Bremen. Now we're going to have a foul for over the back on Alexa Garrison. And I've got to assume Coach Stasiak's not going to be happy with that shot selection.
That was a little bit of a force for Alexa.
40 seconds to play, first half. Rochester up 19-16, and Bremen with an opportunity to tie it with a three-point here on this possession. Rochester in the full-court press. Arndt gets it in, throws it away, gives it to Malco. Malco pulls up five-footers off the mark, no good. Rebound being tipped around, and Hubbard has it with 30. Five-foot. Now quickly to Box. Box being hounded by Holland. Box crosses the timeline finally, and then steps on the timeline over and back. Good defense by Alexa Holland.
Stayed right with her. Box tried to juke and jab one way or another, and Holland just stayed right in front of her the whole way.
Murphy, who's nursing an ankle, comes back in. Abbott will come back in, and Odell and Garrison to come out. 24 seconds to play, first half. Rochester up by three. It's been as big as 11 in this quarter. But Rochester will look for the final shot of the period as Malco runs the point, top of the key. Crosses through the center circle and actually stands right in the center circle. Now works away right side with 15. No pressure being applied. Now down to 12. Malco dribbles with 10. Malco moves with 8. Gives to Holland top of the key with 7. Holland gets a pick from B with 4. And then the pass is tipped away and stolen by Box with 1. Box has her shot blocked at the buzzer, and we're at halftime. After the first half, the Lady Zebras clinging to a 3-point lead of 19-16. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
Rochester leads 19-16, and the Lady Zebras will start with the basketball. Well, the 8th grade of the junior high season opened last night.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The 8th grade, I apologize to the 7th grade because I don't remember the score. I know they fell a little short to Warsaw, but
okay.
The 8th grade beat Warsaw 31-28.
Very nice.
Yeah.
It's a good thing you had your knee surgery this week. Stay in your seat.
Yeah, well, I didn't have mouth surgery.
Ah, okay. Well...
I stayed in my seat, yes. Was I quiet while doing it? No.
No. Well, that's a little mustache.
So here we go, the third quarter again. Rochester will start with the basketball, their original five on the floor. And Bremen will start in that 2-3 zone, which Brad seemed to work late in that second quarter.
It did. It caused Rochester a little bit of trouble. They not hitting very many shots, and Bremen taking advantage by rebounding.
Holland fakes the three, drives around the defense in the lane. Baby hook or the teardrop shot in the lane is no good. Malco with a rebound on the baseline. Feeds down Little Pollock. Jumper on the way out the window is good. Rochester works and works and works until they get it to be inside, and Rochester puts it in for two and extends the lead to five. Box around the defense. Against the double team now, against Rochester's double team, now to Jennings, who holds above her head. Cross-court pass is tipped away and taken away by Malco. Malco, middle of the floor, one-on-two break. Jumper over the double team is no good, but a foul coming on Bremen. That's going to send Malco to the line for two. What did Rochester shoot in the first half?
Like 18%. Yeah.
Which is better than the number Randall gave us.
Yes. His is probably a little more accurate.
No way. Malco with a line for two. First one for the sophomore is on the way and good. She'll have one more. 22-16 Rochester. Malco with one more free before the Lady Zebras. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 7-11 to play in the third quarter. And Malco with one more. Malco ready. The second one is on the way and good again. Nothing but net on both of them. And Rochester's pushed his lead back to 7 all of a sudden. 50 seconds into the third quarter. Little half-court trap. Nope, Rochester's going to go to a man-to-man. Schaefer to Jennings.
Yep.
Jennings. Zarnicki at the elbow. Right baseline to Schaefer. Jumper short. Nothing but air. Picked up by Abbott, who gives to Holland. Alexa runs to our right. Rochester by 7. Through the center circle. Works to the right wing now against Bremen's 2-3 zone. Picks up her dribble. Gives to Malco top of the key. Looking for Murphy in the paint. Has her. Fades down low to Abbott. Her jumper's good. Great ball move by the Lady Zebras, and the lead is back to 9. 25-16. Fox brings it up the floor against Mount, makes it Holland. It was 6.5 to play in the third quarter. Whoa, got away with the carry there, didn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Now to Schaefer, top of the key, who's at the free throw line. Outside of Jennings, just inside the arc, left baseline is no good. Rebound fall for Malco, comes out of there with it. Behind her back dribble, now runs for Rochester. Malco quickly to Murphy. Murphy in the paint, stops, pops, good. And now Bremen will use a timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Back at Rochester High School, third quarter, 6:08 to play in the third. Rochester now up by 9 at 27-16. How about maybe 11, 27-16? Val Ceceris, the sports editor of the Rochester Sentinel, has given us some scores.
Yeah, from Caston, they lead North Miami 33-27 at half, boys. Tippecanoe Valley boys lead Northfield 18-5.
Zarnicki puts one in for two for Bremen. Is that it?
And Knox girls over Culver girls, 23-21.
Holland's three is no good. Box with a rebound for Bremen. Works against Holland. Now to Jennings. Back to Box. They cross the timeline right. 27-18 Rochester. Box on the right wing. Looking for Hubbard. Now has Jennings on the right side. The left side that is. Now Jennings backs out and resets for Bremen. 5:25 to play, third quarter. Jennings at the free throw line. Cut off by Abbott. Now to Box, top of the key. Feeds down low. Tipped away. Pollock has it. Turnover Bremen. Rochester runs. 27-18. Rochester the lead. Becky Malco fakes, drives, pulls up. Off the back is no good. And the putback by Pollock is no good, but a foul coming on Hubbard. And B will go back to the line to shoot two.
Malco had a good look. She just couldn't get it high enough
almost,
on the glass.
Almost like she short-armed it.
Yeah. Like lost her power in her legs. I don't know if that ankle's giving her problems.
So Pollock back to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras, who lead by 9 at 27-18. B fires the first one. Good. One more coming for the senior.
Got quiet enough. You could just about hear her breathing.
Entire game. Like a Saturday afternoon crowd in here. Second for Pollock on the way. No good on the front of the iron. The rebound to Bremen. Zarnicki has it. Now to Schaefer. Schaefer runs for Bremen, now to Box. 5 minutes to play in the third. To Jennings. Oh, she got away with the travel. Outside to Schaefer. Feeds down low to Zarnicki. Zarnicki over the defense is good.
Bremen number 22.
28-20. Rochester, 4:50 to play in the third. Lady Zebras by 8. 2-3 zone now, still for Bremen. Malco, no look pass to Holland, who passes up a wide open three. Gives to Malco left side. She drives it left and throws the basketball out of bounds. Bremen going to get it back. That's a tough place to try to throw an entry pass from there.
Well, we didn't see Rochester pass up too many threes in that first half, so I don't know if something got said at halftime. They're going to try and work her down low and pass up a few of those
that
in the second
be.
Half.
Well, it's worked to this point.
Yeah.
Over the defense, Pollock tips the ball away and steals it, gives to Murphy. Rochester runs up by 8. Murphy, cross-court pass to Holland, down low to Abbott. Jumper is short, gets her own rebound. The putback is no good, but a foul coming on Hubbard. Is that four?
I got three.
Okay.
Bremen foul, number 13, Chelsea Hubbard. Checking in with Bremen, number 15, Gabby.
Yeah, I think that must be four.
I think that's four on Hubbard. And Buck back into the game for Bremen. And Bailey Abbott will go to the line to shoot two for Rochester, who lead by 8 at 28-20 with 4:24 to play in the third quarter. Abbott. Left-handed free throw on the way. Good. I'm not sure if it was going to get there. One more coming for the junior. Trying to push this lead back to double digits for the Lady Zebras. Feely out, but with one more with 4:24 to play in the third. Abbott's second one. Too hard this time, and the rebound to Box and Bremen. 9-point lead for Rochester. Ahead to Czarnicki. Czarnicki in the paint. Jumper on the way. Short. The rebound to Czarnicki. Her putback is no good, but a foul coming on Malco. I think Czarnicki got away with another travel in the lane. Regardless, she's going to the line to shoot two as Becky Malco picks up a personal foul with 4:16 to play in the third. Rachel Czarnicki at the line, a 5'8 junior. She'll have two for the Bremen Lady Lions, looking to cut into this 9-point lead. Free throw on the way is in and out, no good. She'll have one more. 4:16 to play in the third. Rochester up 29-20.
This is only the second trip to the free throw line for Bremen.
Second one is good this time. 29-21, Bremen. Rochester runs up by 8. Lob pass down low to Pollock. B backs away and throws up a shot. It's good. Rochester's lead back to 10 at 31-21. It was 19-16 at halftime. Box over the defense. Has the ball tipped away and stolen by Murphy. Murphy middle of the floor. No look pass to Abbott. Abbott's layup is good, and Rochester up by 12. Timeout, Bremen. It is a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. .53 to play in the third. Rochester up 33-21, and Bremen with the basketball will go to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. And here comes a half-court trap by the Lady Zebras. Box through the center circle, works away right. Lob pass is tipped away and stolen by Murphy. Murphy runs, now holds up. Good idea by the senior. Did not have the numbers.
Right.
And Rochester will reset up by 12.
Now half-court trap for Rochester's working pretty well here in the second half.
Malco in the paint, dump pass down low to Pollock, and B loses is out of bounds.
She turned the wrong way. When she got the basketball, she turned the wrong way. She
turned into traffic.
Turned into the defense and lost the handle on the ball.
Bremen has it back down by 12 with 3:25 to play in the third. Half-court trap again. Jennings gets it ahead to Schaefer. Schaefer bounce pass, tipped away, gives it, Czarnicki gets it back. Out of box. Box over the defense to Jennings. Works right wing behind the arc, and her pass is knocked out of bounds by Abbott. It'll stay on the far side to the Bremen Lady Lions. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 3:15 to play in the third. Rochester up 33-21. Jennings looks to get it in. Does so to Schaefer. Schaefer lob pass to Czarnicki. Shot over Pollock is too hard. Buck with the rebound for Bremen. She gets the rebound and drives. One dribble to Czarnicki at the free throw line. Dumps it to Schaefer on the baseline. Schaefer against Murphy. Bounces it off of her foot and out of bounds. Rochester going to get it back. Turnovers.
I've got Bremen for 15.
Okay.
Rochester for 9.
3 minutes to play in the third. Rochester up 33-21. And now we've got a 2-3 zone still by Bremen. Abbott at the free throw line. Oh, traveled, no call.
Yeah.
Now to Holland. Holland left side, gets it to Murphy, top of the key. Now right side, quickly to Malco. She drives the baseline, rises up, shot over the defense, no good. Pollock's putback is no good. And Abbott with the rebound. We're going to foul on Bremen. I believe it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester. Michaela Box picked up her third.
Yep.
And Arndt will come back into the game for Bremen. And she'll replace Schaefer for the Lady Lions. 2:37 to play in the third. 33-21 Rochester. Lady Zebras of basketball. Baseline left. X looks to get it in. Holland studies. over the top of the defense to Malco on the right wing. Becky holds against the 2-3 zone. Left side to Holland. Just about threw it overhead and out of bounds. A couple of dribbles. Dumps it down low to Abbott. Abbott kicks it out to Malco on the right wing. Malco to Murphy to Holland. X in the paint. Back to Murphy. Step back three as passed up. She faked it. And now gives it to Malco. Dumps down low to Pollock. B over the defense. Off the glass is good.
Good patience.
Yep. 35-21 Rochester. Biggest lead of the night with 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. And Pollock, another steal. I'm not sure how many she has, but she's got a handful of them. And now gives to Holland. Rochester runs again. Holland hesitates. Now in the lane. Kicks it out to Malco. Three in the way. Right wing. Good! 38-21. Holland steals the inbounds pass. Her putback is no good. And the rebound to Box. Oh, boy.
That was close.
Now gives to Jennings. Jennings against a double team. Back to Box. Through the timeline to Czarnicki. Czarnicki that has it stolen by Malco. Make that Abbott, who gives to Holland. Behind her back dribble. He gets a double team and throws it up for Gaz to Malco with a minute 30. She splits the defense. She's in the middle. Dumped down to Pollock. Backs away in. Throws up a shot. No good. A lot of contact. Rebound to Bremen. Box with the rebound. Michaela Box runs. Left side of the floor. Now middle of the floor for the Lady Lions. 38-21 Rochester. Minute 15 to play in the third. Gets a pick. Runs around the defense. Now we're going to have a legal screen on Czarnicki. And Rochester going to get it back after another Bremen turnover.
Czarnicki will pick up her third.
Minute 13 to play in the third. Rochester up 38-21. Bremen has two timeouts left. Rochester with all five. And it looks like the way the play was called there, that Coach Stasiak will look for the final shot of the period.
He's going to pull him out.
Maybe.
Spread.
Holland holds. 2-3 zone still for Bremen. They extend it out to the volleyball line. Under 58 seconds to play in the third quarter. Malco with the basketball and a Murphy outside to Holland. X dribbles near the Rochester bench at the volleyball line. Now to Malco, back to Holland on the near side. 45 seconds. Holland a couple of dribbles over the top of the defense to Malco. Malco in the paint, dumps down low to Abbott. Jumper is good. So much for taking the last shot of the half or the quarter. 40-21 Rochester, 30 seconds to play in the third. Box over the top of the defense to Jennings. She drives the baseline, and she's going to be fouled by Murphy as she goes to the basket, and it'll be out of bounds to Bremen, baseline right.
Murph will pick up her first.
Zebra foul, number 54, Carly Murphy.
27 seconds to play.
Get out, jump to the ball, B, stay in.
Box looks to get it in to Czarnicki and has her pass knocked out of bounds by Murphy. Box will look to get it in. 25 seconds to play in the third. Rochester up to 40-21 to Jennings. 8-footer off the window, no good. And Murphy's going to be fouled on the undercut again.
Yeah, it's her second.
Zebra follow, number 54, Carly Murphy.
So Bremen out of bounds again with 21.7 to play in the third. Lob pass inside to Czarnicki. She loses it. Ball being fought for. It's loose. We're going to have a tie-up, and Bremen going to keep it with 17.4 to play in the third. 40-21 Rochester. Lady Lions have it out of bounds, baseline right. And Alexis Jennings will look to trigger it in. Jennings over the top of the defense to Box. Box against Holland. Back to Buck. Buck in the corner to Jennings, and she travels. 11.5 to play in the third quarter. Rochester will get the final shot of the period, up by 19. Holland has it. She'll cross the timeline with 7. Holland quickly works to the near side of 5, hesitates, now drives it right with 3, looks back door, ball loose, Balco picks it up, throws up a prayer at the buzzer, no good. After 3, Rochester leads 40-21. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Why does it work like that?
Every
game we go to, it's kind of like that.
I'm guessing the halftime talk was pretty good.
Oh, yeah, you think?
Yeah, maybe.
So you're giving all the credit to Tony?
Okay. No.
Rochester starts the basketball. Looks like Brayman's in a 2-on-2 zone. Actually, we've got a chaser on Murphy. Is that right? Malco around the defense at the elbow. Law pass inside to Pollock. Jumper is good. Now Rochester up by 21. Did it look like to you somebody was chasing Murphy?
Yeah, but I just think they're trying to play man-to-man, and her man was slow.
Box turns it over to Murphy. Murphy, right side of the floor. Cross lane pass to Holland. She puts it up. No good, but a foul coming on Bremen. And if that's Michaela Box, that's her fourth. But Alexa Holland will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras.
Bremen foul, number 12. Michaela Box.
36 seconds gone in the fourth quarter.
That was on Box. That's her fourth.
Alexa Holland.
So now Bremen has two with four. First one for X is no good. She'll have one more. Hart comes in for Bremen, and Buck will sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 7:24 to play in the game. Rochester at 42-21, and Holland with one more for the Lady Zebras. Second on the way is good this time. About a three-quarter court press, and actually the half-court crab coming for Rochester's defense. Over the top of the defense to Arndt. Arndt on the baseline. Shot partially blocked, and now we're going to have a tie-up between... Oh, we're going to have a reach-in on Holland. Okay. She reached in and tied up, who I thought she tied up.
They called it on Murphy.
Oh.
That's her third.
Hubbard. I thought Hubbard and Alexa Holland had the tie-up. Pass goes in bounds to Zarnecki. Out to Arndt. Arndt, right side to Box. Cut off by the double team. No look pass to Jennings to Zarnecki, and she travels again.
Turnovers piling up for Bremen.
Seven to play in the game. Rochester at 43-21. Boy, this is what they needed after the Whitco game.
Yeah. At 24 turnovers on Bremen.
Three-quarter court trap by Bremen. Alexa Holland dribbles out of that to Malco. Malco, left side of the floor, around the defense to Murphy, top of the key. Murph, no look pass to Abbott, and she loses it out of bounds. And that was going to be a wide-open layup, too.
Well, and that's where Rochester's shooting percentage improved in that third quarter. So they're getting a lot more shots from 3 feet out.
Yeah, to go.
Yeah.
They still had those shots in the first half, just couldn't get them to go. 43-21, Rochester, Bremen to the basketball. Jennings with the basketball, now to Box. Michaela Box playing with four fouls. Step back three on the way for the seniors. No good. And the rebound to Arndt, who loses it right to the hands of Holland. Holland runs on the far sideline. Holland left side of the floor. Cross lane pass to Malco. Her jumper is good as her feet was taken out from underneath her, and she's down. Slow to get up. And now quickly on the other side of the floor is Bremen. And Pollock steals the basketball again to Holland. 45-21 Rochester, 6:10 to play in the game. Alexa Holland dribbles behind the arc in the right wing. Now hands off to Malco. Malco, a couple of dribbles back to Holland high on the right side. Now over the top of the defense to Malco.
I don't think she wants the ball.
I think that surprised her a bit, didn't it? To Holland, back to Malco. She drives it left. Cut off to Abbott, who sends it over the defense to Holland. Holland left wing, or the right wing that is, gives to Malco on the left side. At the volleyball line is Rochester. She drives in the paint, rises up, fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line for two.
Freeman foul, number 11.
That foul's on Jennings, her second, team seventh.
Shooting two.
5:40 to play in the ball game. Rochester at 45-21. And Malco will have two. Eyes the first one, lets it go, and it's good. She'll have one more. Back into the game is Schaefer for Bremen, and Arndt will come out. I'm telling you, B. Pollock is approaching a triple-double.
Okay. I've got nothing to dispute that.
So. 8 rebounds, 7 steals.
Okay. There you go.
Second one is no good. And the rebound is knocked away but picked up by Schaefer, and Bremen runs. Schaefer then is fouled on the reach-in by Becky Malco. With 5:36 to play in the ball game, Rochester up 46-21. 8 rebounds, 7 steals.
It's a good night.
That's a fair night. Yeah.
With,
how many points?
16 points.
Yeah, that's a fair night.
Yep.
Box runs the point for the Lady Lions. She crosses the timeline, drifts right, now drives right in the corner to Jennings. Jennings back to Box, quickly down low to Zarnecki, and we're going to have a foul on Murphy. The shot is good. And Carly Murphy just picked up foul number four, and Zarnecki will go to the line to shoot one.
Zebra foul number 54.
And that's going to send Coach Stasiak, I would think, back to the bench, but not so far.
Number 22.
Now Alexa Garrison will come in for Rochester.
She's at the line shooting one.
So Rachel Zarnecki will have one free throw to look to complete the three-point play, and Murph comes out with four personal fouls. How many points does Murph have tonight?
Six.
Okay.
Zarnecki has nine right now.
Looking for a 10th point with this freebie, and it's good.
And she's the only one to score for Bremen in the second half.
No kidding.
She's got nine of their nine second-half points.
Full court press by Bremen. Holland has it. Holland over the defense to Pollock. B holds now off to Holland on the right side. Holland drives the right inside the right three-point line. Now to Malcolm in the center circle. Becky holds against the man-to-man defense, I think. Now to Holland. Holland drives it right, hesitates inside the three-point line, looking down low to Pollock. Good defense by Bremen, and the entry pass is kicked away by Schaefer. It'll stay with Rochester out of bounds with under five to play in the game, up 46-24. Bremen had 16 points at the break. Holland's got to get it in over the top of the defense to Malco, and she backs it out and will run clock, and she runs around Jennings, down low to Holland. They'll make that to Garrison. Her putback's good. First shot was no good. The putback was good.
Alexa.
And now the lead is 48-24. Box. Zarnecki. Back to Box behind the arc on the right wing. One dribble over the top of the defense to Schaefer. 18-footer on the way is good as she kind of fell away from that one. And she got it to go to make it a 48-26 game. Full court press by Bremen. Malco's pass is tipped away. Holland has it. Rochester's going to have to use a timeout, and they will. It's a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. .23 to play in the game. Rochester up 48-26. And after the Lady Zebra timeout, they'll have the basketball underneath the Bremen basket, needing to go the length of the floor. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Abbott gets it in to Malco. She crosses the timeline without any trouble. Gets it in the lane. Now kicks it outside to Abbott and gives back to Malco high on the right side. Coach Stasiak directs traffic top of the key. Now Malco in the paint. Gives down low to Garrison. Her layup is good. Alexa Garrison gets a great feed from Malco and finishes it. And it's 50-26. Schaefer in the paint, rises up over the defense and gets it to go. Stasiak will use another 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. .57 to play in the game, 50-28. Rochester on top. And they use their second timeout, so they're down to three. Bremen has two left. Bremen will be a full court press as Bailey Abbott will look to trigger it in. Abbott gets the green light, gets it into Holland at the time, is the corner, dribbles away from trouble, and now we're going to have a reach-in foul by Schaefer.
Huh? Wow. Kind of late.
And Alexa Holland will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Schaefer will pick up her second.
Murphy will come back in the game, and she'll replace Bailey Abbott for the Lady Zebras. Four personal fouls.
At the line, shooting one and one, number 10, Alexa Holland.
Holland has one of the bonus. The sophomore grabs the ball and shoots. No good. Rebound to Zarnecki. Zarnecki now gives to Schaefer. Schaefer in the left corner to Jennings. Top to Box. Box drives it right. Throws up a shot. We're going to no good, but a foul coming on Malco, and that's going to send Michaela Box to the line to shoot two. the kid in the box. Sophomore, beg your pardon. I said senior earlier.
Malka picks up her third.
Box has two. First one for her Lady Lions is on the way and good. She'll have one more. It's 50-29. 3:44 to play in the game. Box with one more for Bremen. Eyes a second one. Lets it fly. No good. And Murphy's a rebound. Gives to Holland. Rochester will look to run some clock here, I'm guessing. Now Malco, high on the left side near the timeline. Drives it left. Now in the paint. Dump down low to Garrison. Garrison against the triple team is going to be tied up, and it's going to go to Bremen. Three and a half to play in the basketball game. Rochester up 50-29. Alexis Jennings will cross the timeline with the basketball, working to our left. Jennings now top of the key. Inside the arc, jumper over Murphy on the way. He's no good. High off the back of the rim. Holland grabs the board and runs. Now Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's slow up here a little bit. We're up 50-29. Let's take some time off the clock. What do I know? Dumps it down to B. Pollock, and it goes.
Yep, two more for Pollock.
B. Pollock has two more, and it's 52-29. 3 minutes to play in the game. Jennings in the corner to Schaefer, just inside the arc. Her jumper's no good. Hubbard with the rebound. Her putback is no good. And Garrison with the board. Holland gives a head to Malco. She'll cross the timeline left. Now middle of the floor. Out to Holland on the near side. Between the rings. Works right side. Crossover dribble. Goes around the defense. Kicks it out to Murphy behind the arc. That was the worst foul than the one that was called on her a little bit ago.
I would agree with that.
Murphy against a double team. Got to get rid of it. Does to Holland. High on the left side with 2:25 to play in the game. Rochester at 52-29. Now to Malco on the near side. Malco around the defense. Just inside the arc, top of the key. Now gives back outside to Murphy. She'll reset. Murphy drives in the paint. Gives it out to Holland. Rochester running some clock. Now high on the left side is Malco. 2:10 to play in the game. And now Jennings picks up a foul.
I begin to wonder if Freeman was going to be able to get a foul.
And Becky Malco will go to the line to shoot one and the bonus with 2:09 to play in the game. And Arndt will come back into the game for Bremen and Schaefer to sit. 52-29 Rochester. Becky Malco with one and the bonus.
She's in double digits again tonight.
Do we have three there?
Malco with 10. Pollock with 18. That's it.
Malco with 11 now. She hits that free throw. But I think everybody that's been in has scored, yes? Maybe besides Odell?
Yeah.
One more coming for Becky Malco. Second one for the sophomores on the way and good again. 54-29, 2:09 to play in the game. A little man-to-man pressure. Now Coach Stasiak calls off the dogs and Jennings will bring it up. Alexis Jennings against Holland. Across the timeline right. Drives it right inside the three-point line. And we're going to have a reach and foul on Alexa Holland. And that's going to send Jennings to the line to shoot one in the bonus for her Lady Lions. Under two to play in the game. Rochester up 54-29. Our next broadcast here on WROI will be a conference action as the Rochester Zebras travels to Tippecanoe Valley to battle the Vikings. Jennings free throw no good. Murph with the board. You can hear that game here on WROI. Start time around, 7:30-ish. Malco around the defense. Picks up a dribble, gives to Murphy. Murphy holds, drives it left. Two dribbles, now to Holland with a minute 40 to play in the game. Holland a couple of dribbles out to Malco near the timeline and the volleyball line. Drives it around the defense in the paint. Now kicks it out to Murphy with 100 seconds to play. Holland inside the arc. Jump pass outside left to Malco with a minute 25. Malco then is fouled by Jennings, and that's going to send the sophomore Becky Malco back to the line to shoot two this time.
Jennings, fourth.
Jennings at the line for the Zebras, shooting two. Becky Malco.
A minute 25 to play in the game. Malco has two. Becky eyes the first one, lets it go, and it's no good. She'll have one more.
And that's a guy's game on Friday night.
What'd I say?
Just that you had one on Friday night. Let me clarify that a little bit. Guys play on Friday night at Valley.
Yeah. The girls are home Saturday night with Valley.
Number yeah.
15, Gabby Park. Number 20.
Coach Stasiak will clear his bench as well as Hannah Odell will come back in. Murph is done. Did you know what he told me?
I can't even imagine.
I think that there's like one more home game left. Two more home games after one more after Valley.
Right, I think you're right, yeah.
Moore has a season gone.
Yeah, five games left, and three of them are on the road.
Number 14, Bailey Van Meter.
Something Bailey like Van that. Meter in the game. Saray Carpenter in the game. I don't think anybody else can come back into the game. Well, I guess there's one more in there. As Malco will look for one more free throw. Second on the way is no good, too hard. Route, and Malco comes out of there with it. Becky against Box, backs it out, gives to Van Meter on the near side. Bailey Van Meter, a couple of dribbles back to Malco in the center circle with 1:15 to play in the game. Rochester up 54-29. Pass to Hannah Odell. Back to Malco between the rings. Left side to Van Meter. Van Meter over the defense to Odell. Back to Malco with a minute to play. Malco drives it left and is fouled by Arndt, and that's going to send Malco back to the line to shoot two with 58.5 to play in the game with Rochester up 54-29.
At the line for the Zebras, shooting two, number 20, Becky Malco.
First one by Malco is good, and Hyatt will come in for the first time, Madison Hyatt, if Becky Malco makes this free throw. She made the first one, she'll have one more. Second on the way, good again, and she's done. Her evening's done, and now for the second game in a row, she's had a fantastic night in the books.
Yeah, 14 tonight for Malco.
Coming off an 18-point performance against Whitco on Saturday. 58.5 to play in the game. Rochester up 56-29. And now basically the JV in the game for Bremen and Rochester. Bremen with the basketball going to our left. Buck with the basketball. Drives to the top of the key now. And I'm not sure who that was. Was that Andrews? Brianna Andrews? And Bailey Van Meter picked up the foul on the shot.
Line four, Bremen, shooting two, number 14, Ashley Lucas.
I don't think so. She's hurt, so she's not playing. I think it's Brianna Andrews, I'm guessing. First one on the way is on the good. She'll have one more. 44.9 to play in the game, 56-30. One more coming for Bremen. Second no good. The putback for Bremen is good. And that putback by Zellmer. And it's 56-32. Bailey Van Meter brings it up, gives to Hyatt high on the left side. Hyatt backs away from trouble with 30 seconds to play in the game to Van Meter. Van Meter backs it out between the rings at the volleyball line. Works the left side. Bounce pass to Hyatt with 25. Down low to Garrison. Garrison grabs the basketball, gives it to Hyatt on the far side with 20. Against a double team, loses it out of bounds. Bremen going to get it back. 20 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 56-32.
Number 14 for Bremen on the floor is Trisha Mosier.
Mosier with the basketball, drives it right, just inside the arc, throws up an 18-footer short. Rebound to Bremen, back to Mosier with 8 seconds. To Buck at the free throw line, now in the paint, drives, throws up a shot, no good, foul on the shot with 4 seconds to play, and she'll go to the line to shoot two. Gabby Buck, a 5-7 junior, will go to the line to shoot two freebies for her Bremen Lady Lions with 4 seconds to play in the game. Buck's first one good. She'll have one more. 23-point lead right now for Rochester, and Buck has one more freebie. Buck ready. Second on the way is no good, and the ball is knocked out of bounds by Saray Carpenter. It'll stay with Bremen with 2.9 to play in the game. It's Bremen basketball, I think. Yes. Gall will look to get it in over the top of the defense. Shot on the way is no good, and another foul on Rochester. Good heavens. 1.6 to play in the game. And going back to the free throw line is Bremen, and Zellmer will do the shooting.
And Carpenter going to pick up her second. Tony's going to call over to talk to her so she don't get her third here before the end of the game.
Zellmer at the line to shoot two for her Lady Lions with 1.6 to play in the game. Free throw on the way is good, and she'll have one more. One more coming. Second of the way for Bremen is no good, and we're going to have the over the free throw line violation before the ball hits the rim. Rochester going to get it back, and with 1.6. Rochester's going to move their record to 11-4 overall, and that'll do it. 56-34 is your final here at Rochester as the Lady Zebras defeat the Bremen Lady Lions. Post-game show coming up next on 92.1 WROI.